और चलिए सीधे आपको मुंबई लिए चलते हैं। सुधींद्र कुलकर्णी इस वक्त एक प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं।
टू आर ऑफिस द ऑब्जर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशन, वी थैंक यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग आवर इनविटेशन टू कम टू मुंबई, इवन दो देयर वर ऑलरेडी इंडिकेशंस दैट देयर सम फोर्सेस वांटिंग टू स्टॉप यू एंड दे हैड एक्चुअली थ्रेटन्ड द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ऑफ the Gulam Ali concert and succeeded in getting that concert called off. In spite of this background, you agreed to come to Mumbai. We are most thankful to you, sir. Our original program was to have a media interaction organized for you at our office as a prelude to the main function for which you have come, the
let me hold it
release.
Sir, niche. Okay.
So this is the main function, friends, which is going to happen this evening at 5:30 at Nehru Center. We had received threats from a certain organization, and I have no hesitation in taking the name of that organization, the Shiv Sena, which had threatened the Nehru Center that if they do not cancel the program, they would disrupt it in the typical Shiv Sena style. उन्होंने धमकी दी थी कि Shiv Sena style में हमारे प्रोग्राम को वो disrupt करेंगे. इसके बावजूद मैं ये कहना चाहता हूं कि आज का कार्यक्रम तो होकर ही रहेगा। आज जिस कारण के लिए हम यहां बैठे हुए हैं वो एक मीडिया इंटरेक्शन कसूरी साहब और मुंबई के पत्रकारों के बीच, तो आपके बीच मैं नहीं आना चाहूंगा। आप कृपया कसूरी साहब को सुनिए और आपके कुछ प्रश्न हो, सवाल हो तो आप अवश्य पूछ सकते हैं। प्लीज लेट्स हैव अ वेरी प्रोडक्टिव interaction, the first interaction, media interaction between Honorable Kasuri Saab and the media, which I want to reiterate is in furtherance of the noble cause of peace between India and Pakistan.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kulkarni. First of all, I'd like to express my unhappiness, sadness at what's been done to you, a thorough gentleman, a scholar, and a thinker. I've known him for many years, and I'm most upset at what I see. Why have I come to Mumbai? It's a city where my father did his law degree. It's a city where he was imprisoned at the age of 19 in the Quit India movement during the freedom struggle. I'd heard a lot about this city. And I want to pay a tribute to the city. It's a city which through its film industry has enabled people of South Asia to understand each other because they adopt a very simple language. Whether you call it Urdu, Hindustani, Hindi, whatever that language is, it's a unifying factor. It brings the people of South Asia together. So these are all the reasons why I wish to come to Mumbai. It's the commercial capital of India. It's a very, I would say, an inclusive city, and as a political worker, I recognize the right of people to protest. I have myself been to prison many times. I have faced police lathi charges. I have faced tear gas. I know what political opposition is, but I've always understood that as long as it is peaceful, it's justified. It is inherent in the constitution of Pakistan, India, and of other great democracies. that you have a right to protest. But what's happened to Mr. Kulkarni is, I think, beyond that legitimate right. Why have I come here? There's another reason. I have seen how quickly it is possible to change people's perceptions. The peace process started with the famous visit of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee to Islamabad, when the joint statement between Pakistan and India was issued. It was the joint statement of January 2004. After that, it was all the way, you know, going forward. Mr. Vajpayee was followed by Dr. Manmohan Singh, and he, with great diligence, carried forward the peace process. And in fact, it was during his tenure that we were able to achieve so much that you will find in this book. I think it was the most productive peace process, starting from Mr. Vajpayee's period to the time that I left office and Dr. Manmohan Singh was still Prime Minister. It was the most productive peace process between the two countries since independence. As far as the perceptions of the people are concerned, I'd like to share with you how quickly they can be changed. The process, I said, started in 2004. I don't know, a couple of years later, whenever, there was a cricket match in Lahore. Matches, as you know, are substitutes for battlefields, particularly if they are between India and Pakistan. Only the other day, you saw what happened in a match between India and South Africa. But Pakistan and India have a special type of, they arouse a special type of fervor. But can you believe it, that India won in Lahore, and the young boys and men of Lahore clapped India, cheered India, and ran across the field with Pakistani and Indian flags. What does it tell you? Don't ever estimate the intelligence of the ordinary people. Once they are given a positive impetus, a positive leadership, a positive message, they are not inherently stupid. So I have great faith in the common man in Pakistan and India. And I want to share my story with the people of Mumbai. And I'm particularly grateful the way this book was received in India and the way it was launched. Former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh was there. If Mr. Vajpayee's health had been good, I would have invited him. But instead, he was very ably represented by Mr. Lal Krishan Advani, who's a great friend of Mr. Kulkarni. In fact, I invited Mr. Lal Krishan Advani to Islamabad, and he came with him. And it was during that visit that Katas Raj temple was restored. And we used that opportunity, it's a historic temple, and we used that opportunity for Mr. Advani to inaugurate that temple. And therefore, I have many reasons to be here, and I'm open to any questions that you may have.
तो जो कुछ हुआ, जिस तरीके से स्याही पोत दी गई सुधींद्र कुलकर्णी के चेहरे पर, कसूरी को आप सुन रहे थे, कसूरी साहब ने भी कहा कि ये बिल्कुल गलत हुआ है।